Hi everyone and welcome back. Paul here from TechLink, and this will be a quick video in which I want to show you how to reactivate your Discord account if for some reason it has been disabled. There are two scenarios under which your account could get disabled, and we're going to have a look at each one of them and see what options you have. So make sure to watch through the whole video to find out how to reactivate your Discord account. But before we get into that, I would like to introduce you to DGRT, who's been kind enough to sponsor this video. Their Winix HD video converter software is an all-in-one solution for video processing, so you can now convert, edit and compress 4K videos without losing the quality while reducing the file size by up to 90%. I'll leave a link in the description below so you can check out the software for yourself. Now, as I mentioned previously, there are two scenarios with two different solutions. In the first one, let's say you disabled your account by yourself simply because you wanted to take a break from it or wanted to stop receiving notifications from them or whatever. Well, this is a very happy case, and you can regain access to your account by following a few easy steps. All you have to do is head over to their website on discord.com and try to log in with your credentials. You should now see a notification saying that your account is disabled and you cannot use it, and the option to return to the login page. But if you look closely, there is another option that says restore account. So click on it. And that's it, your account is back online. That's how easy it is. Now, in the second scenario, your account has been disabled because you violated their terms of service or community guidelines, or at least that's what they claim. I'm not saying you necessarily did that, because sometimes what might happen is that even the simple fact that you were part of a server that did break their terms of service could get your account disabled, even if you weren't active in that community. If this is your case, you should also get an email that looks like this or close to this, where they explain vaguely why they decided to disable your account. The good news is that most of the times you can appeal their decision, and the success rate is high enough, so it's worth trying. In order to do that, you need to head over to their website on discord.com and click on support. There are many ways to get in touch with them, but this method is just better than sending a random message to their Facebook page or Twitter account. So click on submit a request, and from this drop-down menu select trust and safety. You then need to enter your email address. Now, it is very important that you insert the same email address that you used when you register your account. Moving on, under how can we help, select appeals, age update, other questions. From the next drop down menu, select appeal an action taken on my account or bot, and finally select an action was taken on my account. You will now see three statements that you need to confirm by ticking these boxes. Obviously, you might want to read through them so you don't submit any false information. Also, if you register your account using a phone number rather than an email, you now have the option to insert it in here. In the end, in the subject tab, insert something like appeal regarding my disabled account, or something like that, and finally explain them your case. Obviously, this will differ from one user to another. So if, like I mentioned earlier, you were part of a server that broke their terms of service, just explain them you were unaware of this and you won't be joining any of those channels in the future. If you know you did something wrong, just mention you won't be doing that anymore and kindly ask them to restore your account. And that's pretty much it. You need to wait for a reply from them, and unless you did something really bad, you should get your account enabled again. Also, another thing worth mentioning is that once you receive that email saying that your account has been disabled, you have 14 days to submit an appeal, after which your account will be permanently deleted, and at that point there is no way to get it back. With this being said, it's time to end this video. If you found it useful, please give it a thumbs up. And if you did manage to restore your disabled Discord account, I would like to hear from you in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.